wherever and whenever.
Woo, that's right.
He is in a class by himself, just like yourself, Hillbilly Jim.
Thank you, sir. It's very kind of you. Well, I'll tell you what, we got two athletes right now in the ring here that are in class by themselves. Those guys there are tough, and they're well matched tonight. I'll tell you, this crowd here at Madison Square Garden is really enjoying this.
Very even indeed. The Red Rooster at 240 pounds, the Blue Blazer at 227. Rooster, of course, managed by Bobby the Brain Heenan, who is conspicuous by his absence, and the Rooster simply has not functioned as well.
Let me put you straight on a point here, Rob.
All right. Roll over.
There is a lot of dissension, and I'm putting this extremely mildly, between the Rooster and Bobby Heenan. So when you're talking about him being managed by Heenan, forget that. That no longer exists. The Rooster, he's somebody who can speak his own mind, and he has proved that quite adequately.
Ooh. Boston Crab.
But he's in trouble here.
Yes, deep trouble. We'll find out how tough he is right now.
Ooh. Rooster's having trouble getting back into a good position. He may do it, though, because the Blazer doesn't have him perfectly pinned with that.
No, Lord, he's got his arms on him right now. He had his arms up. There he is. He's got the ropes now. He's got to break it now.
Yes, he was lucky there. He had his right arm under his chest.
But you know, Lord, what you were saying there about Bobby Heenan, I know real well. I'll tell you that Bobby Heenan cannot be trusted by no man. And if you think you can trust him, son, you're fooling your own self. Because I've had many dealings with him, and I know all about the brain.
Nice move by the Blue Blazer. He has a series of them going and has had since the opening bell here. The Red Rooster really has been unable to get anything going so far. It has been the Blue Blazer.
Well, that was a very interesting situation there, Rod and Hillbilly Jim. Well, Hillbilly Jim will know about this for sure. But he had Red Rooster pinned, and Rooster, at the count of one, put his foot out to try and feel for the rope. He couldn't feel them near enough, and he panicked. He only just made it out before the three count. He was close to being beaten right there and then.
That's right, Lord. You know, he had misjudged where he was in the ring, and that's very important for a wrestler, you know, because a lot of times you're very close to a rope, and you can stick your leg up there and break the count. And this Red Rooster was just about ready to get the pinfall on him, and he didn't realize it.
He nearly did that. You're absolutely right. You have nice move there.
A neck breaker by the Red Rooster, one of a few times in the match so far that he has had things going in his way. I can count about two other very, very brief moments of the match, but other than that, it has been all Blue Blazer. Right now, the Blazer trying to find out exactly where he is and what he's doing, and the Rooster is quick to follow up.
He's vicious with left foot. I tell you, this guy here knows how to cut them knees. Look at that.
Right off that head. Forehand.
He might have him there, guys. I don't know. No, he kicked. Beautiful.
And that's exactly what I mean by damaging moves. You see, here's Rooster damaging his man, whereas when Blazer had those chances, he didn't do that. Look at this move.
Oh, vicious. I'll tell you what, Lord, you're exactly right, sir. That takes it out of a man right there. Two or three little maneuvers like that, and you forget where you're at in there, just enough where you could get pinned.
Yes, and now he's adopting a very, very cavalier attitude, and that's not going to win him matches.
The Red Rooster. The Blue Blazer, a hard right hand by the Rooster. The Blazer, stunned, seeing some stars, I'm sure, is whipped across the ring and now clotheslined to the floor. But the Rooster is slow to follow up.
What a tremendous clothesline.
Oh, he thinks he's got him. Come on.
That was close. It was very close.
Yeah, see, Rooster would have loved to have got victory that way in that fashion over somebody as good as the Blazer. But I don't think he'll ever do it. Not that way. You've got to have those shoulders securely pinned, and you've got to take one leg too. You've got to hook your man completely.
Oh,
my Lord.
The Rooster saw it coming, gets out of the way, and the Blue Blazer goes all the way to the back.
Oh, nice one.
Indeed, an almost victory here for the Red Rooster. And he is complaining to the referee, burning the wax in his ear, saying, hey, I had it. You didn't count fast enough.
You know, he's working that shoulder. I fear he's injured that shoulder. And I tell you what, this could be the turning point of this match right here. Because this Blazer is giving him everything he wants right now. He's taking the best shot, and he's still standing in there. But I believe he might have an injury right there when he hit that post that time.
That steel ring post. Caught it square on the shoulder.
Yes, it did.
Some really great moves by the Rooster now. In the beginning of this match, he was being outshone by his opponent. Not outclassed, but outshone by the brilliant a blue blazer, but none of the blazers moves, well, one or two here and there, were fairly damaging, but not the way Rooster has been attacking his man. No.
Blazer trying to figure a way of getting out of this one and going to a power move of sorts. However, the Rooster, did he grab some trunks or the back of that mask which the Blue Blazer wears?
Grab that hair, sir. I'll tell you, that's some of Bobby Heenan's tactics. He teaches that to all of his guys. And you know, when it gets a little tough on them in there, instead of them bearing down and being real athletes, they resort to those kind of tactics. That's cheating. I'll tell you, nothing but cheating. Nothing else but it.
Right now, the Rooster going to work with a knee on that shoulder. That's the Blue Blazer ran right into the ring post just a few moments ago. He's got that body part hurt, and he continues to work on it.
The Blue Blazer is doing the right thing right now. He's allowing Rooster to stay on top, but not in a damaging situation. And he's trying to get his second wind going. It looks like he may have achieved that.
I think he does.
Oh, that could have got him, fellas. He landed on his shoulder, too, as well.
Hooking the leg. Almer, he is kicked off, and the Rooster again complains to the referee, saying, hey, man, let's get him the count. All that time allows the Blue Blazer just a bit more time to recover and recoup, and now he has the Rooster in a scissors. Rooster does a somersault, and look at this by the Blue Blazer. And look at this by the Blazer.
Reversal.
That's wide. One and two. Almost. That looked like a bit of a slow count. And the Rooster, very, very disgusted with the Blazer, sends him between the second and third row.
And I think he was a little disgusted with himself there, because that was one of those lapses of concentration I was telling you about.
Indeed.
He allowed himself to be hooked with that backslide, and now he's trying to make amends for that mistake.
And outside he goes, and bounces the head of the Blue Blazer off that apron. The Blazer shaking his head as the Rooster is back in and strutting around like the cock of the block that he is.
See, that's what I don't like about this guy here. He's very cocky. Still him worried about what he's doing in that ring there and wrestling like a man there. He wants to show off.
Oh,
not impress somebody. But look at this. Look at this. There it is.
Indeed. Yes. Look at it. However, the Rooster grabs a hold of that top rope. But he's jarred free of it. Again, close with no cigar. Lapse of concentration. And almost caught again.
He's allowing the referee to distract him.
And
that could be fatal for the Rooster.
A double shot to the throat, followed up by a chokehold by the Rooster. Stops the Blazer in his tracks.
I think the Rooster had every right to complain to the referee, though. You can't go around knocking men's hands off the ropes, even if you are the referee.
A hard elbow off that second rope by the Rooster. And again, he comes crashing down on the Blue Blazer here at Madison Square Garden in New York. Rotron got along with Lord Alfred Hayes and Hillbilly Jim bringing it all to you.
You see, this Red Rooster here is something else, because he's keeping the punishment on this guy, and you know he's going right back to that same shoulder that he injured a while ago. He's a very smart wrestler. He knows what he's doing, and I'll tell you, he has got a lot of intelligence in there, and this part of the brain is probably influenced in there as well.
That's a hallmark of a good wrestler. If you get something going, keep at it. Keep nagging away at it all the time.
Hyperextension here on both the shoulder and the elbow on the left arm. The left side of the Blue Blazer with the Red Rooster putting it on. The referee checking closely with the Blazer, seeing if he wants to call it a night.
That's not enough for him to submit, I'll tell you right now. This guy here is mighty tough. He's double tough, and I got a feeling he's got another run left in him tonight.
Oh, I'm sure.
All right, this
is
your
part of it right there.
Yes.
As he comes out firing with a pair of forearms, and here is a whip. Wow, and he telegraphed that, and the Rooster took advantage of it.
Yes, he showed a little inexperience there, the Blazer. Just a little bit of inexperience. He's been placing himself perfectly, but that particular time, you should never duck your head when the man is going through the ropes. When he's coming off, maybe, but not going through them.
Exactly right. You know, he's gone right back to that hold again, keeping the pressure on him. I think he senses that he's got this guy injured here some sort of way, and he's going to stay on that shoulder and get every little bit of it he can.
Yeah, that's into a hammer line.
Oh, good.
It's certainly one way of tying up Blue Blazer, Hillbilly.
Yes, sir. He hasn't got to worry about those aerial moves when he's got down the mat flat like
no.
That. No, sir.
He certainly hasn't. And the Blazer.